left kidney in longitudinal section, in which you see the, all the calluses are dilated. This central area, this is the parenchyma, and this is the, these are the calluses which are dilated minimally. And in these calluses you will see there are, now this is a grounded echogenic area approximately measuring 4.4 millimeter, and in the lower pole dilated, this is the lower pole dilated calyx, this is the upper pole dilated calyx with the central hanging, you know, hanging echogenic area of approximately same size that we have seen in the upper lower pole calluses. These giving no shadow at all, these are consistent with clots or the calculi and formation in this patient. However, now you see there are two calculi in the proximal ureter. This is the pelvis, here is the ureter, it starts from here, and there are two calculi impacted in it. One, and this is the second one. One, and this is the second one. So there are two calculi as a cause of obstructive uropathy in this patient, clearly seen. Here you will see again. Tabankaru. The kidney is otherwise working normally. The parenchyma has been perfused normally. And this is our case today, which is two calculi in the proximal ureter as a cause of obstructive uropathy with two concretions or clots in the dilated calluses of the left kidney. Thank you.